Welcome to Illusion Training and Education. I am Dr. Mahesh Jagwani and today I am going to talk about the rule of 27.
I am going to show you this case from one of our doctors who has prescribed a 4 unit BruxZir bridge in the lower left quadrant, that is from the 3-5 to the 3-8. Let's have a look at the preps first. The preps seem just about okay. These are mostly knife edged margins all throughout, so nothing substantial to notice there. There are a few undercuts on the lingual aspect of the 3-8 and also on the lingual aspect of the 3-5. Let's check the occlusal clearance now. The occlusal clearance over the 3-5 seems just about okay for a BruxZir. Occlusal clearance really does not come into play in the 3-8 because the opposite tooth is absent. The one problem that I see in this case is probably this region. The patient might have lost these teeth for quite some time, because of which the upper 7 has kind of supra erupted. You can see the palatal portion, the palatal cusp of this tooth heading towards this ridge here. This region I think will lead to the violation of the rule of 27. The rule of 27 is basically something that we use in the lab to evaluate whether a BruxZir bridge is going to be successful or not. What we can do is we can determine the height and the width of a particular connector from our designing software. Square of the height multiplied by the width of the connector, this value should be 27 or more. In case it is less than 27, then there are good chances that the bridge might fracture from that particular connector, and as a result the bridge is not going to be successful. So as a dental laboratory, it is very important, we always inform our dentist in such cases that it is better to go for a PFM bridge because the rule of 27 is being violated. I have the scanned images of this particular case, so let's have a closer look at the scanned images and I will again explain the rule of 27 to you in detail. So this is the scanned image with the articulation of the upper and lower modals according to the bite on our software. And this is the bridge which was designed in the software. So let's have a look at the individual connectors now. So this is the first connector which has a height of 1.151 mm according to the software. And it has a width of 3.345 mm, as you can see. So now we multiply the square of the height with the width to get a value which is 4.431. So this value is less than 27, which means that this connector is not strong enough for the bridge to be successful. Let's have a closer look at the second connector now. It has a height of 1.858 mm and it has a width of 4.147 mm. So now when we calculate again, we multiply the square of the height with the width to get a value which is 14.316. Again, this connector is very weak because this value is less than 27. Similarly, we move over to the third connector now. It has a height of 1.604 mm and its width is 4.455 mm. So now again we calculate, we square the height and multiply it with the width to get a value which is 11.461, which again is less than 27. So as we saw from the calculations, all these three connectors are not strong enough to make a BruxZir bridge. So the bridge is actually very weak in all the three connectors, and hence we suggest a PFM bridge in this case instead of a BruxZir bridge. So this is another case that I have. I don't really have the models as this is an old case, but just to show you, I have the scanned images. And this is the 3-unit bridge which we designed in the software for this particular case. Let's have a closer look at the connectors individually. This is the first connector which has a height of 3.121 mm and it has a width of 5.063 mm. So the calculation for this connector, that is the height squared multiplied by the width, is 49.31, which is more than 27. So it looks like a sound connector and will pose no issues as far as the strength goes. So let's take a look at the second connector now. It has a height of 2.356 mm and the width is 5.455 mm. So if you look at the calculation for this connector, this value comes up to 30.279, which is just above 27. So I think we are safe here. As we saw, both these connectors are sound enough and this is a good case for a BruxZir bridge.
Well, that's about it for today's episode. Please write in your comments, suggestions and requests to feature certain specific procedures at the email address mentioned below. I want to thank you all for watching this video on behalf of everybody here at Illusion Dental Laboratory. See you next time.